I think we probably have to first of all talk about the NSE's index hitting 32,000, and of course gaining almost 2% again today. We've seen the market rally strongly, now up well over 15%. Your thoughts about the strength, the sentiment for stocks these days?
Yeah, I think the sentiments are still positive, and moving forward, it's still going to remain so for some time.
We saw, for instance, today Dangote Cement gaining almost 5 naira, closing at 145 naira per share. A bit of a surprise given the fact that it has come down a little bit. But can you just talk to us about the demand we're seeing for Dangote Cement?
Yes, Dangote Cement, like you know, is a major player in the cement industry. You know, it's a dominant player in that industry. And obviously, investors would like to take advantage of the brand, you know, to be able to at least make some returns from Dangote Cement. But having said that, we discovered that also WAPCO also gained today, not just Dangote Cement. And if you look at that industry generally, it's a very profitable industry.
And that's sorry to interrupt you there, but I wanted to move on to Dangote Sugar and the news that they announced about their acquisition of Savannah, the plantation, and the backward integration program moving ahead. And I see that the market clearly liked that news because the share price gained today.
The share price of Dangote Sugar actually moved from 715 kobo to 760 today to gain 45 kobo. But like you rightly said, yeah, it was, I think one of the reasons why it moved was because investors actually responded positively to that news. As part of Dangote Cement's, Dangote Sugar's backward integration strategy, they actually wanted, the acquisition is going to provide them with opportunities to synergize and to actually optimize their costs. You know, so they were able to, and they also be able to take advantage of to source their raw materials locally now through this acquisition.
All right, we see flour mills being one of the gainers, rather losers today, shedding about 9 naira after the release results yesterday. So clearly there are some things that the market doesn't like about those results. I will be speaking to the CFO later on the show, but talk to us about the changing sentiment for flour mill shares, if at all.
I think flour mills, to me, from my analysis, I think is a bit overweight now at the moment. And I think investors are beginning to see that, and that's why they're trying to take out a profit. Don't forget that it actually came up from around 16 naira. So, and I mean, for a stock that came from 16 naira and is already above 18 naira, you expect investors and portfolio managers to actually take off their profits at the moment and actually wait for it to come down. And the fact that the result wasn't actually as expected as what analysts actually expected also sums up the old statistics, and that's why we see a loss in the price today.
Okay, of course, we'll be hearing more from the CFO later on the show. But let's move on to the bond market. Today, we know that the kickoff of the retail bond trading today, on very thin volumes, I heard only about a million naira worth of trades were done. But talk us through how that kicked off today.
Yeah, it kicked up just like the equity markets actually kicked up as well. We have a platform already on the system to trade the bonds, and today we had about 14 deals, close to the volume was about 700 volumes. But the most important thing to take away from this is that it has started, and it started on a smooth note, and it's going to provide investors opportunities to actually diversify their portfolio, like we know, and to also earn fixed returns on their investment.
So you see,
but having said that, Lagos State bond, their 80 billion Lagos State fixed 14.5% Series 1 bond was actually listed today on the market. So I want to believe that too will form part of the bonds that could be traded.
Okay, well, of course we'll be watching that very closely. But your thoughts about how the growth that you're anticipating from trading in bonds? I mean, if you look at many other markets, the bond market is actually bigger than the equity market. So your thoughts about that dynamic? Do you think we're likely to see that on? We know, of course, it's very big on the OTC market, but looking at the listed markets, do you anticipate that bond trading will be as big, if not bigger, than equities?
Moving forward, I actually see it even getting bigger than equity, you know, because it has started on a good note. There's a platform for you to exit your position. You know, you have a secondary market. You know, the fears in the past had been that you don't have an opportunity to exit your position, and the retail investors are actually cut out of the whole show. It was just OTC, you know, dominated. You know, it was more of an OTC thing. But now, you expect more players in the market. And moving forward, by the time the corporates actually also buy into this idea and come to the market to raise their debt instrument, obviously it's going to provide more liquidity and more avenues for investors to also diversify their portfolio.
I guess all these developments must be very good for business for you. I mean, now we're seeing the equity market get quite vibrant. We're seeing value traded closer to 4 billion naira these days. We're seeing the bond market kick off. So business must be good for you, I imagine.
Oh yes, and it's like the outlook is even looking better, because now you can earn income from the two sides. You can earn income as a bond trader, as well as an equity trader.